Hi, welcome back to my kitchen. Today I'm showing you how to make my smoky tomato raita. It's such a wonderful accompaniment to most Indian meals, and also just with a bowl of dal or when you're doing Middle Eastern kebabs with some pita bread. So let's get straight into it. Let me show you how I make.
So we're going to start by dry roasting some dry whole red chilies till they just take on some color. So this is where the smoky flavor in the raita comes from, because we dry roast the red chilies and we also dry roast the tomatoes before they go into our yogurt. About 2 minutes on a hot girdle plate, and my tawa is quite hot, so I'm just making sure I turn them around. So like you can see, the chilies are taking on this blackish color, taking on a nice black color from the dry roasting. And now I'm going to add about 4 to 5 whole cloves of garlic onto my pan. And that's about it. I'm going to turn off the gas. So this goes straight into the blender for later. So next we're going to dry roast the tomatoes. Again, this is a dry tawa, and I've just put the tomatoes onto the hot tawa, and you can see it'll start getting blisters on its skin, and this is what we want. This is what creates the smoky effect in the raita. So you just want this to happen mostly on the whole tomato. So this should take about 5 to 7 minutes depending on the flame. So it's been 7 minutes, and you can see the skin has started to come off. It started to char in several places. So that's it. I'm going to turn off the gas. I'm going to roughly cut them into small pieces and add the tomatoes to my blender and whisk this whole thing together to make a rough paste. Yeah. So this is 1 cup of yogurt. I'm going to add that to my serving bowl. This is the paste we prepared of the tomatoes, the red chili and the garlic. I'm going to add this into the yogurt. Now is add some salt to taste, how much ever you prefer. I'm going to add about 1/4 of a teaspoon. All we have to do now is temper the raita and it will be ready to serve. For the tempering, I'm using mustard oil. And when you're using mustard oil, what you need to do is, before using it actually, you heat it till it starts to smoke and gets very, very hot. So I've done that here. And then you turn it off and you bring it down to room temperature. Then you heat it again and you use it as normal oil. This is only if you're using mustard oil. If you're using regular refined oil, then you can skip this step. But I feel this raita gets a very good flavor from using mustard oil, so I recommend it. So I'm going to wait for this to cool, and then I'll turn on the flame and proceed with my tempering. So I'll start by adding just 1/4 teaspoon of mustard seeds, black mustard seeds. I'm going to let them splutter. And they have spluttered. I'm going to add some asafetida. Again, this adds a nice flavor. Asafetida is hing. Then I'm going to add a curry leaf, 1 stalk of curry leaves. And let this splutter for a bit. And then I'm going to add 2 green chilies. And give it a shake, and then I'm going to pour it on my raita. And my kitchen smells wonderful. And then you just mix everything together. And it should look this way. I mean, there should be coarse bits of tomatoes that you can see You should be able to see the green chilies. That's how this raita is served. It's a very rustic home style raita. It's not something which is completely smooth and really watered down. So there you go. Your smoky tomato raita is ready.